Hi there. Today we're looking at the FX-991EX scientific calculator, and I'm going to show you how to think about doing probability simulations if you don't have actual manipulatives or things you can use. So we're going to look at ways to do a coin toss, you know, heads or tails, ways to do rolling two die and getting the sum, or even one die, and even ways to pick a card from a deck of cards. So first, I'm here in the class Wiz, the 991EX, and here's the menu. It's a icon-based menu, and what we want to do is go into a table because we're basically going to use the table to simulate our samples. And so we have to enter a function, and let's think about a coin toss. So a coin toss is either heads or tails. So there's two options. So we could use, instead of an actual function, we could use the random integer number here. So if you look down here where the period is, in the red it says random integer. So I'm going to enter random, alpha, and then that button, and it brings up random integer. So my function is going to be a function that gives me back a random integer, and I have to tell it what range to put it in. So if I'm thinking about, say, a coin toss, I want to assign a value to heads and a value to tails. And it can be any numbers. I could do 1 and 2. I could do 0 and 1. But let's just do 0 and 1. So 0, say, represents heads. And then I'm going to put a comma. So the comma, if you look, is here at the back parentheses. And it's in yellow. So I'm going to hit shift parentheses and 1. And then close my parentheses. So basically my function is to bring back a random integer number between 0 and 1, so basically 0 or 1. And if it's 0, that means I've tossed a coin with a heads, and if it's 1, I got a tail. And so then when you hit equal, it's going to ask you for another function. Well, we don't need another function in this particular simulation, there you go. And so we're going to just hit equals. And now here's how many times you want to toss the coin, right? So right now it's going to toss it 5 times. So maybe I want my students to start at 1. Well, it's going to do it 5 times. So if we look, here's my 5 tosses. So here's X represents my number of toss. So toss 1, toss 2, toss 3. And F of X, remember, is just a random number. And 0 represented heads. So I got on the first toss heads, second toss tails, heads, heads, and if we scroll down, tails. So out of 5, I got 3 heads and 2 tails. So when we're thinking about simulations, we're doing theoretical. So theoretical is it should be 50-50. Well, in this particular case, now I only did 5 tosses, it wasn't 50-50, right? So then maybe we want to do more tosses. So you could go back and do it again. And this time, let's change how many samples we take. So instead of 5, let's do, say, 30. And now when I hit enter or equals, I'm going to get, you know, different values. But if you scroll down, I can see and I can keep track of how many ones, how many ones, zeros. Am I now closer to that 1/2 or 50%? So this is just a way to collect costing coins, for example, without having to actually have the coins or have the students doing it. Might get noisy, whatever your reasoning might be. So now we can use the same thing. Let's go back. So we're going to hit all clear and get us back here. We can do the same thing. Let's think now about dice. So if I wanted to simulate rolling dice, maybe I wanted to do rolling 2 sets of dice, right? So I want to roll dice. And when I roll a dice, what are my options? Well, I can get a 1. So I'm going to change this value to a 1. I can get a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. And so I want random numbers between 1 and 6 this time. And that represents the toss of 1 die. So when I hit equals, now I do want to enter a second function because the first function represents my first die, and the second function is going to represent my second die. So I'm going to, again, do alpha period to get that random integer in there. And so my second die is also going to be between the numbers 1 through 6, and we're going to close our parentheses, and we would, again, let's leave it at 30. That's a good value. And so now here we go. And so here is, let's say we're either just recording the values that we got each time toss, or maybe we're looking for the sum of 7. So here we've got a 1 and a 3. That's a sum of 4. 4 and 5, sum of 9. 6 and 6, sum of 12. So students are recording very quickly all their sums of the dice without having to actually toss the dice. We've simulated tossing the dice, and now we can quickly add up and figure out how many of those 30 actually are 7. What's our probability? Is it close to the theoretical probability, which for tossing, rolling a sum of 7, it with 2 dice is 1 out of 6 or 6 out of 36. So let's go back again. And one more thing where you have to be maybe a little more creative, right? So I'm going to hit all clear again. I still want my random integer, but let's say I want to pick a deck of cards, right? So a deck of cards, if we give every card a value from 1 to 13, so 1 is the ace and the king is the 13, right? The queen is the 12, the jack is the 11. So we have numbers 1 through 13, so that represents the card number value, right? But when I hit equals, I also have 4 suits, right? So I have the suits, you know, however I want to number them. I have hearts, spades, clubs, and diamonds. So let's say I give each one of those a value 1 through 4. So let's say hearts is 1, spades is 2, clubs is 3, and diamonds is 4. So my second function is going to represent whether the card I pick is from which suit. So let's just make that between 1 and 4. So again, we're being a little creative here, and we have to keep track of what we're doing, but it's now, what's the probability of picking a 10? And it could be a 10 from any of the suits. So that's what we're looking for. So when I hit equals, and let's just do 30 again, I picked a 4, and it came from the clubs, I believe was the 3. So I picked a 4 from the clubs. And if we scroll down, did I pick a 4 somewhere else? And it doesn't look like I picked a 4 anywhere. Oh, there's a 4, but this time it was from our hearts. So we have to decide, does it matter which suit? But there's 4 chances of picking a 4, and that's what we're really looking for as far as the probability. So lots of different ways to think about using random integer to help you do probability simulations if you don't have the actual tools. You don't have a deck of cards. You don't have a set of dice. You don't have coins to toss. You can use your technology to help you do some of those simulations.